I'm still one of the people that whose fathers came from Italy, came to America.
She came from Salemi, Trapani, the same place Johnny Shoes' parents came from.
It's a little village, I believe it's called Petra Prezia.
Castello Mare de Golfo in Sicily.
Both sets of grandparents, both came from Avellino.
My father's family was from Avellino, Mirabella. My mother's family was from Sicily.
This is Boston's Not Then. This is one of the oldest Italian-American neighborhoods in the country. I'm Stephen Pascantilli. These are the streets of the North End, where I was born and raised, and where my family has been for four generations. Today, I'm going to tell you a story about Italian-American immigrants. Why they made this their home, why they came here, and how they made it the most vibrant Italian-American community in the country. That's the story I'm here to tell you, about the families, the friendships, the food, and the hard work. Southern Italians started coming here in the 1870s, fleeing starvation and worse.
Italians left Southern Italy by the millions from about 1870 to about 1900, right in that period is the sort of the great migration out of Southern Italy. A lot of the residents of Southern Italy really believed the region was cursed. Bad weather, disease, there's cholera. There are natural disasters, Mount Vesuvius, Mount Etna, huge earthquake in Messina. About 15 million people leave Southern Italy. It's a stunning number of people.
My mother, she was a very young girl when she came here in 1920. She was 3 years old. She made a transatlantic journey with her two sisters, my Aunt Rose and my Aunt Jenny. And my grandmother, Mama Nuzza, was a long, arduous journey. When they finally got here from Sicily, my grandfather, Papa Gico, was awaiting them and took them to a little apartment on Unity Street before they moved to 452 Hanover Street, where my mom spent most of her childhood and actually was married from 422 Hanover Street. That's where she met my father.
I think almost half of Southern Italy migrated to America. And these people really had to have had it very difficult coming from Italy, not being able to speak the language. And they gave up their homes, they left their parents, never to see, in many cases, never to see them again. And they worked very hard. They worked as common laborers. Most of them worked as common laborers to make a home for themselves. They moved to the North End, overcrowded conditions, very close to being a slum area, definitely a ghetto. And it was still a crowded North End. Everybody lived in tenements, crowded conditions.
Italians arrive in the United States with no real identity as Italians. Instead, their loyalty and their identity are to the different provinces and regions in Italy. So Calabrians and Sicilians, Napolitan, Avellanese, etc. And when they come to America, they settle in that exact same manner in Italian neighborhoods.
You know, like I live here, and then you come from Italy, naturally you don't know me, and you don't know my way. If you came from Sicily, you had a different accent than I would talk, you know? We talk Napoletana, they talk Sicilian.
And so you had Calabrians down at one end, you had Sicilians at one end, you had Villanese at another end.
When you come from the same paella, you have a lot in common.
If you're not related to someone, your cousin is related to them.
Yeah, there you go.
I have a lot of cousins. I got lots and lots of cousins.
We used to have grand holidays together here. Our aunts and uncles who didn't live outside of the north, they used to come here for the holidays. We used to have our Easter's here, our Christmases here, Thanksgiving's here.
Way up to the clouds, away from the maddening crowds. We can sing in the glow of a star that I know of, where lovers enjoy peace of mind. Let us leave the
confusion. We ate the macaroni, the meat, and then we used to call it a panzetta, a big loin like that. And I used to stuff it with the eggs and everything.
The holidays, if you walk the streets of the North End in the old days, you can smell the meatballs, you know what I mean? You can smell the gravy, and if you happen to stop in there and run up, sit down and eat. Famous words, sit down and eat. Eat. That's why, and they used to tell me, eat, Johnny. Then when I got fat, they said, why don't you stop it?
Sunday was my most favorite day of the week. Go to 9 o'clock mass at St. Stephen's Church, dressed to the nines, you know, the North End is famous for their sartorial splendor, always looking to get dressed up in their Sunday best and having a great Sunday dinner. It was just a wonderful, wonderful day, spending time with food and with family, two very, very important things for Italian kids growing up in the North End.
When I was a kid, I remember my grandmother walking barefoot for St. Anthony, because that was her patron saint, and they'd walk with these giant candles all day long and just walk the streets with the saint as a thank you.
See, the feast came from Sicily. They were calling all the people that came from that paesa to come and join in.
And you got dressed up on the Sunday, and I would walk with my grandmother to St. Anthony's feast. I would get so excited that I could walk with her. But I had to wear shoes. They wouldn't let me go without the shoes.
I guess it was densely populated. There were a lot of people. I don't know the statistics, but the apartments were crowded. We had a four-room apartment, and there was five of us and my mother being together in that one apartment.
As kids, we used to go up Fleet Street, go to the public bathhouse, meet all the kids from the North End. They had no showers. In fact, these bathrooms were all in the hallways.
And this is She Street now we're coming onto. This street, by the way, it's been documented. Back like in the 30s and 40s and 50s, it was probably the most densely populated street in the country. A lot of people from Avellino lived in this street. Villanese, they called them. In one building alone, there was 110 people that lived in it. The families were big, the apartments were small. You wonder sometimes how people made it.
So please meet me in the plaza near your casa. I am only one, and that is one too few. On an evening in Roma, don't know what the country's coming to.
The North End back then, they were comprised of many, many corners. There were so many boys, you know.
It was a little bit of an island. I felt like I was living on an island as a young boy growing up in the North End. My street corner was in front of the pool room, and that's where I met some of the friends that I'm still very, very close and feel very dearly about to this day.
Half the history of this neighborhood, this has been an Italian enclave. And I think that that's one of the reasons why Italians feel so strongly and passionately about their traditions.
imaginary dear.